A very good morning. You're watching Breakfast News with me, Smriti Rastogi. Our top focus this morning is the third International Yoga Day celebrations across the world today. But before getting you all the details related to it, a quick look at the top headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says yoga has played a big role in uniting the world as he leads third International Yoga Day celebrations. UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath and 55,000 participants joined Prime Minister Modi in performing various yoga asanas in Lucknow. Yoga Day events being organized in all states. Prime Minister Modi's ministers performing yoga asanas across the country. Nitin Gadkari heads events in Maharashtra, Javadekar in Manipur. Amit Shah presides over celebrations in Ahmedabad. Yoga events also in nearly 180 countries across the world. Boost for BJP as Shiv Sena backs NDA presidential candidate Ram Nath Kovind. JDU to meet in Patna today to decide stance. Opposition party is to meet on 22nd June. GST to be officially launched on 30th June midnight. Launch function in the Central Hall of Parliament. President, Prime Minister, Vice President, Chief Ministers and opposition leaders to be part of the event. And suspected suicide bomber shot at Brussels railway station. Bomber set off a small explosion. No casualties reported. Incident being treated as a terrorist attack. As the world is celebrating the third International Yoga Day today, Prime Minister Narendra Modi led the biggest gathering at the Lucknow's Ramabai Ambedkar Maidan, where the main event for this year was organized. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, along with other dignitaries, also participated in the celebrations. The event kick-started at around 6:40 a.m. this morning with Chief Minister Adityanath welcoming the Prime Minister and addressing the crowd. Stressing upon the importance of yoga, Adityanath said that this ancient form of exercise helps in bringing world together. Prime Minister Narendra Modi emphasized on the fitness, wellness, and that yoga is a medium to achieve wellness. Prime Minister expressed his happiness over the number of yoga institutes opened over the last 3 years and the demand for yoga teachers increasing. Undeterred by the weather conditions and early morning rains, more than 55,000 people participated in various yogic postures. Meanwhile, tight security arrangements were in place. Senior Superintendent of Police and the District Magistrate monitored the arrangements. United Nations General Assembly had made a declaration in December 2014 that every June 21st would be observed as the International Yoga Day. Last year, the main function was organized in Chandigarh. In 2015, first International Yoga Day was organized in the national capital, Delhi. People in 150 countries and Indian missionaries in Netherlands, Trinidad and Tobago and the United States, among other countries, today celebrated the event. Greeting the people in Lucknow, Prime Minister Narendra Modi applauded them for coming out in large numbers and participating in the event despite of the rainy weather. Prime Minister said that India is leading the world with yoga and wellness. He also emphasized that yoga has evolved over the years and has become a part of every household.
Yog swayam bhi vyakti se समष्टि तक की यात्रा करनी शुरू की है। एक वक्त था जब योग हिमालय में गुफाओं में ऋषियों मुनियों मनीषियों का ही साधना का मार्ग हुआ करता था। युग बदलते गए, सदियां बीतती गई, आज योग घर घर का, जन जन का, उसके जीवन का हिस्सा बन रहा है। लगातार बारिश के बीच भी आप सब यहां डटे हुए हैं। योग के महात्म्य को बल देने का आपका ये प्रयास अभिनंदनीय है। विश्व के अनेक देश जो न हमारी भाषा जानते हैं, न हमारी परंपरा जानते हैं, न हमारी संस्कृति से परिचित है, लेकिन योग के कारण आज पूरा विश्व भारत के साथ जुड़ने लगा है। योग जो शरीर मन बुद्धि को जोड़ता है, वो योग आज विश्व को अपने साथ जोड़ने में बहुत बड़ी अहम भूमिका अदा कर रहा है।
Meanwhile, Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath said that yoga has become a movement and is being celebrated with fervor across the world.
योग भारत की प्राचीन विधा है, हमारी प्राचीन ऋषि परंपरा का प्रसाद है। वेदों सहित सभी प्राचीन ग्रंथों ने योग के महत्व को स्वीकारा है, और अगर कहा जाए तो योग जीवन की एक कला है। अंतर्राष्ट्रीय योग दिवस को उत्तर प्रदेश की राजधानी लखनऊ में मुख्य समारोह के साथ संपन्न कर रहे हैं। मुझे ये बताते हुए प्रसन्नता है कि उत्तर प्रदेश के प्रत्येक जनपद में अनेक स्थानों पर आदरणीय प्रधानमंत्री जी की मंशा के अनुरूप यह समारोह एक जन अभियान और जन आंदोलन का रूप लेता हुआ गांव गांव शहर शहर में बड़े उत्साह के साथ मनाया जा रहा है। एक प्रकार का है, एक पर्व हो गया है।
And for more on this, we'll go across to our correspondent Panchanan Mishra, who is joining us live from Lucknow. Panchanan, despite of inclement weather and heavy showers in the morning, people in Lucknow seemed quite enthused to participate in Yoga Day. What kind of euphoria is being seen there?
Yeah, Smriti, the third edition of this International Yoga Day, the main function was held in Lucknow. And there was continuous rain since morning till the function was over, but there was enthusiasm amongst yoga practitioner. As soon as the Prime Minister came, there was enthusiasm in the environment, and they started practicing yoga. And Prime Minister was also among them who was doing yoga in the rain. He was here around 45 to 50 minutes, and it was quite a good function. But rain causes quite difficulty in this function. But Yogi Adityanath, the CM of Uttar Pradesh, was here. Governor Ram Naik was here. So many cabinet ministers was here. It was quite a good function. And Prime Minister given this message that yoga may bring a good change in the life of everybody. Common people should adopt this yoga in their life like a salt in their food. So this is quite evident that he is continuously batting for the yoga, and despite of due to his regular thirst, it was declared International Yoga Day on the 21st June. So it is quite helpful for the people to adopt yoga in their life and to bring out with a good health in their life. Yes, Smriti.
Thank you so much, Panchanan, for joining us and giving us all those latest information from Lucknow. And International Yoga Day is being celebrated all across the country. Thousands of people participated in the yoga events, along with many politicians and dignitaries across the nation. Here's a look at the report.
Yoga Day is being celebrated in the other parts of the country as well. Heavy rains at several places failed to deter the thousands of yoga enthusiasts. BJP President Amit Shah performed yoga in Ahmedabad along with yoga guru Baba Ramdev. Gujarat Chief Minister Vijay Rupani also participated in the event.
Yoga ko netritva Bharat ko hi dena chahiye aur yog mein vishwa kirtiman bhi Bharat ko hi banana chahiye. Yadi paschim ne puri duniya ko science diya hai to Bharat ne puri duniya ko spirituality di hai. Vishwa ka margdarshan Bharat ke madhyam se hona chahiye. तो आज ये विश्व कीर्तिमान यहाँ अहमदाबाद की इस पुण्य धरा पर बना।
in the national capital Delhi, Union Minister Venkaiya Naidu, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal and NDA's presidential nominee Ram Nath Kovind participated in the yoga event.
Impression art. It's an art. It's an exercise for mind, for body and soul. It brings unity both in mind and also in society. That's why it's catching up the emotions of the people. I hope the younger generation will make this as part of their life and then make a bright future.
Chief ministers of Assam, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and several union ministers attended the celebrations across the country along with thousands other participants.
यदि इतनी बारिश के बावजूद यदि इतनी बड़ी संख्या में लोग यहाँ एकत्रित हुए हैं तो इसी से ये प्रमाणित होता है कि योग को लेकर के कितनी प्रेरणा है, कितना संकल्प है, विश्वास है लोगों में। और मैं तो ये कहूंगा कि पिछले 3 वर्षों में प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी के माध्यम से जिस प्रकार की एक जागरूकता योग और योग के गुणों को लेकर के विश्व भर में हुई है उसका सबसे अच्छा दर्शन आपको यहाँ देखने को मिलता है।
नेवी पर्सनल ऑल्सो परफॉर्म्ड योगा ऑन बोर्ड इंडियन नेवल शिप जलश्वा एंड किर्च इन द बे ऑफ बंगाल व्हाइल बॉर्डर सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेज प्रैक्टिस्ड योगा इन -25 डिग्रीज टेम्परेचर नियर इंडो तिब्बतन बॉर्डर इन लद्दाख। ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट, राज्यसभा टीवी।
For more on this, we'll go across to our correspondent Anu Devan, who is joining us live from Delhi. Anu, various dignitaries also participated in Yoga Day celebrations today in the national capital. Tell us about the mood of the people and what kind of enthusiasm was seen for yoga.
Definitely, Smriti, today in the morning itself at 6 o'clock, all the spaces in the Central Park were really full. You can say it was at a footstep of, at every footstep there was one person. There was not even a single space left for people. They were so enthusiastic relating to the Yoga Day's celebration. But talking to the people, they were saying that it's just a one day event, but they wanted to be, they want this mass participation to be a regular one. So they were even talking about that this yoga has helped them build up very has helped them in all sorts of things like peace, talking about the peace of mind, talking about the health. But they were also emphasizing on the focus of the government, that the government should also focus on creating awareness relating to yoga, its benefits, and creating more institutes and instructors to yoga. Smriti, people here were very happily participating, and they also need more participation relating to yoga day and day, or you can say monthly. They want this type of exercise to be made mandatory for people.
Thank you so much, Anu, for giving us that piece of information. So remember, today is the 3rd edition of the International Yoga Day. People across the world and politicians across the party lines have participated in the celebrations. Meanwhile, President Pranab Mukherjee also urged all the Indians to turn yoga into a habit in order to lead a healthy life. Kicking off the 3rd edition of the International Yoga Day celebrations at Rashtrapati Bhavan, Mukherjee said that ancient Indian practice was useful for curing physical as well as mental disorders. The president wished everyone a healthy life and credited Prime Minister Narendra Modi for taking the initiative to propose celebrations of the International Yoga Day on 21st June, which was later accepted by United Nations.
This is an ancient Indian practice which is very useful for curing disease and also managing the other, particularly the mental disorders.
And it is not just India. Yoga events are being held through the day world over. From New York and Paris to Panama, Yoga Day celebrations are taking place. About 5,000 events are being held across 180 countries to mark the day. On Tuesday, yoga enthusiasts performed asanas at iconic landmarks including China's Great Wall and Britain's London Eye. Some of the countries, including China and the UK, have scheduled events through the week. In UAE, more than 15,000 people participated in the Yoga Day celebrations. Programs were held simultaneously at the iconic Burj Khalifa Park, Zabil Park and Abu Dhabi National Exhibition Center complex in Dubai. Over 1,200 yoga enthusiasts in South Africa's Soweto Township also performed various asanas at the event. The participants included hundreds school children who got their first taste of yoga. United Nations headquarters in New York were also lit up for International Yoga Day in its second year in a row that the United Nations headquarters have been specially illuminated on the occasion of International Yoga Day. Renowned actor Anupam Kher switched the illumination lights. The permanent mission of India to the United Nations is also organizing a session with renowned yoga teachers. The United Nations will also issue special stamps commemorating the International Yoga Day. The stamps will have image of the Indian sound Om and various yogic postures.
जब तीन साल पहले जब प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने इसका प्रारंभ किया था तब और आज में इतना सारा उत्साह बढ़ गया है लोगों में योगा के लिए. आज आपने देखा लोग तो खत्म करने नहीं चाहते थे. तो बस हमारा हमारी ये कोशिश है कि हम भारत के कल्चर का एक छोटी सी भेंट सब लोगों को प्रकाशित करें. लेकिन अब योगा एक ग्लोबल फिनोमिनन बन गया है.
एंड इफ दोस सेलिब्रेशंस आर नॉट इनफ टू मोटिवेट यू टू प्रैक्टिस योगा ऑन अ डेली बेसिस, टेक अ लुक एट दीज डिफरेंटली एबल्ड चिल्ड्रन इन सूरत हु एक्सरसाइज्ड एंड मेडिटेटेड in a yoga camp on Tuesday. A total of 150 children with different kinds of disabilities participated and performed various asanas. We leave you with these visuals as we take a short break.
What is BJP without Narendra Modi?
Modi ji is not separate from BJP.
There is an effort to homogenize the society into a Hindutva society based on the hatred for Muslims.
We have not imposed anything on the people. So our track record is the answer.
For the current government, Kashmir is only about Pakistan and terrorism.
People sitting in Delhi studios should understand that Kashmir is not a political issue.
Watch To The Point with National General Secretary of BJP Ram Madhav only on Rajya Sabha Television.
On to some more national news. Two militants were killed today in a gunfight with security forces in Supor of North Kashmir's Baramulla district. The Rashtriya Rifles, the Special Operations Group of the police and the Central Reserve Police Force surrounded Pazalpura village in Baramulla district on Tuesday evening. This after getting intelligence inputs about the presence of militants there. Combing operations are on to flush out more militants who could be hiding in the region. Internet has been cut off in Supor. The attack comes after militants attacked a CRPF camp in Thral town in Pulwama district on Tuesday. BJP's alliance partner in Maharashtra, Shiv Sena, has decided to support Kovind's candidature for the upcoming presidential polls. Opposition parties will hold a meeting on 22nd of June to select its presidential candidate. They are likely to field their own candidate. The JDU is also slated to meet in Patna today to decide on the party's stand on the presidential poll. Meanwhile, Ramnath Kovind resigned from the post of governor of Bihar on Tuesday. His resignation was accepted by President Pranab Mukherjee. West Bengal Governor Keshari Nath Tripathi has been given additional charge as Bihar Governor.
NDA's presidential candidate Ramnath Kovind resigned as Bihar Governor on Tuesday. His resignation has been accepted by President Pranab Mukherjee. Earlier in the day, Kovind met Home Minister Rajnath Singh, who conveyed his best wishes on the candidature. BJP announced Kovind's nomination for the president's post on Monday, a move welcomed by the Telugu Desam Party, the TRS, BJD, YSR Congress and the Lok Jan Shakti Party.
पवित्र विचारों वाले व्यक्ति हैं और मैं समझता हूं कि उस उच्च पद के लिए उनकी गरिमामयी उपस्थिति उस स्थान पर निश्चित रूप से उस पद को सुशोभित करेगी.
The opposition, however, may not support Kovind's candidature. While Kovind's selection has left parties like the BSP and the Trinamool Congress confused, the opposition parties are likely to meet on June 22nd to elect their joint candidate.
There is no consensus that way. So the parties in opposition are meeting on 22nd to decide their strategy, to decide their future course of action. As far as left parties are concerned, we have been saying contest for president has become battle of ideologies. It has become a battle for safeguarding the Indian constitution. In such a situation, we wish the opposition parties take a common stand to face this contest.
However, the BJP is unlikely to face a tough fight from the opposition. The Electoral College, which elects the president, has a total of 10,98,882 votes. BJP and its allies currently have 5,37,683 votes, marginally away from the halfway mark of 5,49,442. The opposition has 3,91,739 votes, with the rest of the 1,44,302 votes undecided. 71-year-old Kovind is likely to file his nomination papers on June 23rd. The elections will be held on July 17th and the counting of votes will take place on July 20th. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
A delegation of Gorkha Janmukti Morcha on Tuesday met Union Minister Kiran Rijiju and submitted a two-point memorandum demanding a separate state of Gorkhaland. The delegation also apprised Rijiju about the current situation in hills and stressed that the centre should urgently start the process of granting a separate state status to Gorkhaland. An all-party meeting sponsored by DJM decided on Tuesday to continue the indefinite shutdown until security forces were withdrawn from the city. The parties also decided to withdraw from the tripartite accord on the Gorkhaland territorial administration. Normal life in the hill city remained crippled and tensed as security forces patrolled the streets. All the shops except medical stores remained closed and internet services remained suspended. Meanwhile, Union Minister S.S. Ahluwalia has called for a high-level probe into the alleged police firing in Darjeeling, in which three people were killed. The BJP MP from Darjeeling also demanded compensation from the state government for the victims' families. A West Bengal government report has listed forthcoming elections to Hill Council and involvement of militants from the northeast as a reason responsible for the recent violence and indefinite shutdown in Darjeeling.
Resolution, movement for Gorkhaland will continue till its logical end. And the next resolution is that unanimously resolved by all the present political parties, non-political parties, unanimously decided that GTA will be scrapped by the Gorkha Janmukti Morcha as soon as possible without further waste of time.
We didn't say we are not withdrawing indefinite strike. The indefinite strike, of course, is on. But we said it is the onus of this. It is the onus of the state government to create an environment conducive to peaceful movement of people. And it is for the state government, because it is the state government that has created tension. It is for the state government to de-escalate the tension and create a peaceful environment here.
Finance Minister Arun Jaitley today said that GST will be implemented across the country from 1st of July. He said that the Prime Minister and the President will announce this at a function that will be held at the Central Hall of the Parliament on the night of 30th of June. Jaitley reiterated that GST will strengthen the economy of the country.
Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has said the goods and services tax regime will be launched in a two-hour meeting of all MPs in Parliament's Central Hall on the midnight of June 30th. The meeting will be attended by President Pranab Mukherjee, Vice President Muhammad Hamid Ansari, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan and former Prime Ministers Manmohan Singh and H.D. Devegowda.
Sabhi rajnitik dalon ka, sabhi विधानसभाओं का, राज्य सरकारों का इसमें योगदान रहा और एक सरकार से आरंभ हुआ दूसरी सरकार और तीसरी सरकार तक ये एक संशोधन गया है।
GST will be implemented in the entire country except for Jammu and Kashmir. The finance minister said small businesses and firms have been given enough time to prepare for the July 1st rollout, so there was no point in opposing it. He also asserted that the new reform will strengthen the country's economy.
We have for the last 6 months been saying that the date is 1st July. Nobody had any business not to be ready. Even when we have finally announced that it is 1st of July, the readiness will be determined when you have to file your first return, which is 10th August. That also we have extended it to 15th September.
After the launch of GST's rollout at Parliament's Central Hall, President Pranab Mukherjee and Prime Minister Modi will give an hour-long speech on GST. Two short films will also be shown to all MPs and invitees. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Former Calcutta High Court Judge C.S. Karnan was on Tuesday arrested from Tamil Nadu's Coimbatore and taken to Chennai. 62-year-old Justice Karnan has been awaiting arrest since May 9th after being sentenced to 6 months imprisonment for contempt of court by the Supreme Court. He is the first sitting High Court judge who has been awarded a jail term by the Supreme Court. Karnan, who faces a six-month jail term, retired on 12th of June. Justice Karnan, who was transferred to Kolkata after he had triggered a controversy by raking up issues against brother judges of the Madras High Court, including the Chief Justice. Belgian troops have shot dead a suspected suicide bomber in the Brussels city centre after a small explosion at the central station. Nobody else was injured, but the damage was limited. But the incident is being treated as a terrorist attack. It is noteworthy that in March last year, 32 people were killed in attacks on Brussels claimed by the Islamic State group.
Belgium police and army securing the area around Brussels Central Station. This after the troops late evening shot a man suspected of being a would-be suicide bomber. He was shot after setting off a small explosion at the station. No one else was injured in the attack, which set off panic as people ran for cover. Eyewitnesses say the suspected bomber screamed Allahu Akbar before detonating a suitcase.
Moi, je suis redescendu pour rejoindre le quai, là avec un homme qui criait. Et il parlait des djihadistes et tout ça. Et puis à un moment donné, il a crié Allahu Akbar et il a fait exploser la petite valise qu'il avait à côté de lui. Où là, donc, les gens ont pris la fuite, ils sont partis.
With media reports saying that he was wearing a rucksack and a bomb belt. However, the suspect has not been identified as yet and it is not clear if he was known to authorities. Authorities are treating the incident as a terrorist attack. The Belgian Foreign Ministry said there is no indication of other incidents, but the threat level remains at 3, which warns of a possible and likely threat.
About 8:30, there has been an explosion in Central Station here in Brussels. The suspect has been shot by the military who were present at Central Station here immediately after the explosion. We do not know if he's still alive or he's dead. The investigation is still ongoing. We consider this incident as a terrorist act, and luckily there were no other victims than the suspect.
The scene of the attack, Brussels Central Station, was evacuated and closed along with two other stations in the Belgian capital. Belgian Prime Minister Charles Michel thanked security services and Belgian Rail for their courage. The country's Security Council will meet this morning to address the incident. The incident comes more than a year after suicide bombers in Brussels detonated several explosions in the Brussels airport and a nearby metro station. The attack killed 31 people and wounded hundreds. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And that's all we have for you in this edition of Breakfast News. Keep watching Rajya Sabha Television.